In a box by a stream, citizen science at work, surveilling a pernicious problem, road salt.
And that measures the amount of salt in the water. And you can see the spike, really high spike.
High concentrations of sodium chloride are bad news for Pacific salmon that return to spawn in these urban waters. But just how bad, we don't know.
There has been no research at a laboratory level to study that in salmon. And this is a unique opportunity to find out just exactly what happens.
Is that fairly normal, that sort of number of deaths?
Yeah.
While salmon do spend most of their lives in the salty ocean, researchers suspect high exposure to salt right after hatching could be poisonous to them.
It's a big problem, and it's a multifaceted problem. It's not just, for example, the effects on the salmon directly, it's the effects on their whole food source.
The investigation draws on research from around the world and will include some lab work by BC universities. But much of the data will come from volunteers tracking salinity in their creeks and streams.
This is just our hands-on recording data sheet, and we record who's done the measurements.
The research will take 5 years to complete, and time is ticking. Pacific salmon are in decline in areas of BC. Climate change and habitat loss play a big role in that, but small changes could help.
Everybody loves salt. It makes our lifestyle easier in the winter, right? But we believe there are significant environmental penalties associated with salt use. And if we can just get the general public to use a little less salt, if we can get regulatory authorities to apply the salt more wisely, more economically, in fact, we can help the environment and actually save money too, probably.
Benefits that could flow on in many ways. Georgie Smythe, CBC News, Vancouver.